Hey friends, thanks for tuning in. I hope these devotions are a blessing and an encouragement to you. And when you watch on YouTube, I encourage you to hit the subscribe button and share it with friends. And if you're watching on Facebook, you know, hit share or whatever, Instagram, whatever method you're doing. But help me get the good word out. I wanted to talk to you today about the priesthood. Are you looking for a priest, someone to intercede for you, to be an intermediary between you and God, and God and you? Or do you realize that you are a priest? The old covenant required a priest served in the tabernacle and in the temple to bring the offerings of the people to God, to offer up prayers and sacrifices for the people. And the high priest would once a year enter into the holiest of holies on the Day of Atonement to make an offering for their sins. In the new covenant, we don't need that kind of a priest. And so I hope you're not looking for a priest to go to God for you or bring God to you, but that you'll realize that you are a priest. The old covenant needed a priest because there was separation between God and man because of sin. In the new covenant, there is no separation because Jesus is our high priest. He has, if you will, gone into the holiest of holies with the perfect sacrifice, what Hebrews calls that one-time sacrifice for all of our sins. And in 1 Peter, he reminds the Christians that they are priests. Look at verse number 4 with me. He says, as you come to him, a living stone rejected by men, but in the sight of God, chosen and precious. You yourselves, like living stones, are being built up as a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. Well, you are a priest. What does that mean? It means that there's no separation between you and God, that you have the rights and the responsibilities to go to God, to have an intimate relationship with him, to realize that you have been chosen and you are precious to him, that you are a spiritual house. We don't go to a temple to find the presence of God. We don't go to a church building to find the presence of God. In Christ Jesus, we are that temple. We are that spiritual house. We are that holy priesthood. Yeah, that's right. You, in Christ Jesus, are right now a holy priesthood, meaning you have the right and the responsibility to offer spiritual sacrifices accepted to God. That's the whole of the Christian life, really. Us living in an intimate relationship, experiencing his presence, offering up spiritual sacrifices that bring glory to him, bringing people to God, bringing God to people, revealing who he is in this hurting world. Not looking for someone else. So as a pastor, a missionary, my responsibility is not to tell you what God wants for you, but my responsibility is to remind you that you have a very precious and special calling, that you are chosen. You are his priest. And life is about those spiritual sacrifices. Well, then in down in verse number 9, he emphasizes this and he says, but you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his own possession, that you may proclaim the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Now that's good news. We came to Jesus, and every last one of us, we were held in darkness, the darkness of sin, the darkness of the world. But he chose us. And he says, you are now a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own possession. And our calling is to proclaim the excellencies of him. It's never about how good we are as Christians. It's always about how good God is. And so as a priest, I want to encourage you. Make sure that you're involved, that you're connected with the body of Christ, because they need you and you need them. We have only one high priest, and his name is Jesus. And so I want to encourage you. Don't let anything cause you to live as though separated from God. Jesus, through his one perfect sacrifice, has removed all of the separation. And you are his anointed priest. You have direct access to God. You have a right to bring people to God and God to people. And we do that as we proclaim his excellencies. Christianity that focuses on the Christian is not good news, but Christianity that proclaims the beauty of the Christ is incredible news. So live there, priest of the Most High God. I love you. Have a great day.